You know exactly what to do, but for some reason, that's not the behavior that you're performing on a daily basis. And my goal today is to give you some strategies to help you do that. And here's the first one. Here's the first actionable takeaway. Now, we don't have the time for you to actually reflect and do it at the moment, so I would love for you just to take some notes and then sit with this over the next couple of days. On one side of your notes, I want you to write down the 4 or 5 activities that fill your bucket, that recharge your battery, that give you energy. What are the things that just make you feel better? Maybe it is going through a workout, taking a yoga class or a spin class. Maybe it's prayer or meditation. Maybe it's listening to classical music or a podcast or an audiobook. But I want you to come up with a list of the things that fill your bucket and allow you to perform at your best. Then in a separate section of your notes, with great detail, I want you to write down how you spend the bookends of your day, your morning and your evening routine. I want you to write down how you spend the first 60 minutes after you wake up and how you spend the last 60 minutes before you go to bed. And I recognize that every day is not the same. I realize that Sundays and Wednesdays are probably not identical. I also realize that many people have had their routines flipped upside down because of the global pandemic. But I also know that human beings are creatures of habit. In fact, a Duke University study found that 42% of everything we do during our waking hours is habitual, which means almost half of everything we do from the moment we wake up to the moment we go to bed is on autopilot. So you can see how important our habits are. So I realize that your Sunday evening and your Wednesdays might not look the exact same, but I promise you that what you do most Wednesdays and what you do most Sunday evenings will have some overlap. And I want you to etch that out. And then the most important part of this audit is I want you to compare those two sets of notes. And I want to see how much overlap there is. On one hand, you have everything that you know fills your bucket, recharges your battery, and allows you to be the best version of yourself. And then on the other hand, you have what you're actually doing at the bookends of your day. And I want to see how much crossover there is. If you've done this honestly, there's going to be some disconnect. There's going to be a handful of things that you know you should be doing, but you are not making the time to do them as consistently as necessary to maximize your growth and your improvement. So once you've had the humility and the vulnerability and the self-awareness to look internally, now the next step is finding ways to start integrating list number one into list number two. And if you do that, I promise you, you will see your development, your growth, and your performance skyrocket immediately. And this has nothing to do with learning anything new. This is all about implementing what you know you should be doing anyway. You can make this exact same audit with people. Who are the 5 people, the 4 or 5 people that fill your bucket? That every time you talk to them, you leave the conversation feeling like a